In the previous lesson, we learned how to trim objects to remove the parts of them we don't need. In this lesson, we will learn how to extend objects to increase their length up to another object, which plays the role of a boundary. To increase the length of objects like lines, we simply have to use the Extend tool. To get a clearer idea of how the Extend tool can be used, a drawing has been created in advance. To activate the Extend tool, I can either open the Modify menu or click on the arrow next to the Trim icon in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. When I click on the arrow, a short drop-down menu appears, which includes the Extend tool. I will click on it to activate it. Like the Trim tool, the quickest way to use Extend efficiently is to activate it and press Enter before I proceed to do anything else. In this way, every object of the shape is a boundary that can be used for the extension. So, without further ado, I will zoom in on the first example to extend the horizontal lines. As you can see, every time my cursor moves on a line, a preview of the extension appears. If I click on the right side of the first line, then it extends until it intersects with the vertical on the right. On the contrary, if I click on the left side of the second line, it extends until it intersects with the vertical on the left. I can extend both sides of a line, and I can also extend multiple lines if I select them all simultaneously. Once I extend all the lines I want, I will press either Enter or Escape to deactivate the tool. However, there are times when it's easier to define a certain boundary instead of clicking again and again. To prove my point, I will move on to the second example. Let's say I want to extend the horizontal lines up to the second spline. I will activate the Extend tool again and press Enter like I did before. In this way, I have to click at least two times to achieve the desired result. I will exit the command and click on the Undo button from the Quick Access toolbar. Now I will activate the Extend tool again, press Enter, and look at the command line. As happened with the Trim tool, AutoCAD provides us with some different methods for extending lines and curves too. In this case, I will click on the boundary edges to set the boundary over the extension. Then, I will select the second spline and press Enter. At this point, I am going to select all the lines I wish to extend. Notice that the lines extend up to the second spline. That was quite easier and, sure enough, a lot quicker. In the last example, I will show you another useful method for extending objects. Imagine that I want to extend all the horizontal lines up to the vertical line on the left. I will activate the Extend tool again and press Enter. Notice that the three first lines are extended without a problem, but the last two do not extend at all. If I move the cursor to one of those lines, the message "Path does not intersect with the boundary edge" appears. So to extend these lines, I have to either create a vertical line of greater length, or I can select the Edge option in the command line. In this case, I will select the Edge option and then I will activate the Extend mode. Now I will proceed to extend the lines again. Notice that I can finally extend the lines. When I'm finished, I will deactivate the command. When you finish with the Extend option, it is highly recommended that you activate the command again and return the Edge mode to No Extend. The reason I recommend this is because the Extend mode can create confusion when we extend lines and curves. Last but not least, I should mention that although there are more methods for extending lines and curves, the ones that were explained in this lesson are what you will most likely need.